Hello everyone and welcome to Java Forever course. Today's topic is what is Java. Before I jump into the details of how Java works behind the curtains, I want to tell you why Java is so popular. Because it is popular, you know, you use Java for multiple purposes, right from developing desktop applications to web pages. If you go back in time a little bit and understand that companies like Microsoft, it makes money by selling Windows licenses which runs the servers. So Microsoft philosophy is that you run it on any, let me move this on the side. Microsoft says that, you know, you can run it, write the code in any programming language. Microsoft's preferred language is C#, but you can also write code in Python in Microsoft stack, or you can even write it in Java, right? So Microsoft says that you write in any programming language, but run it on Windows Server, right? Because Microsoft wants you to buy Windows servers. On contrary, Java world says you learn just one programming language, Java, and you run it on different operating systems. It could be Windows, it could be, you know, Ubuntu or Linux, right? Etc. You can run it on any operating system. And that's what makes Java so powerful. You know, a lot of companies, especially the startups and all, they want to run it they want to reduce the cost, or, you know, run their operations or business on low cost. So they go with this type of options. And then, you know, or some companies, when they move from one to save the cost, they move from Windows to Ubuntu or Linux, or they run in multiple environments, right? So Java gives them that flexibility or power to run on different operating systems. And that is why Java is so powerful and popular. Now, let me close this. Now, the way any programming language works is that you write your instructions in any programming language like Java, for example. So Java, you write the code here. Every programming language comes with its own compiler, because computers do not understand English. Computers do not understand their machines. They do not understand Java. We as a human speak English. So we learn Java, which is kind of a compromise, right? So that we can talk to computers. We can give instructions to computers. So when you write Java statement, we learn Java and we write Java statement. That language is compiled by a Java compiler. Every language has its own compiler, because the job of compiler is like a translator. It translates that language, you know, that code into machine language, because computers understand only machine language. Now, in general, Java compiler, or any compiler for that matter, creates an intermediate file. It creates a piece of instructions, which usually is taken by an interpreter and feed into machines. This could be Windows or Ubuntu. This is the typical architecture. The beauty of Java, or the power of making your code operating system independent, comes from this piece, the intermediate language piece. This is where Java actually converts, rather than creating one file here and that file is directly fed into computer using an interpreter. Java has one intermediate language, and this language also creates a file. We call it, you know, Java intermediate language. This file is then used by interpreter to give it instructions to Windows operating system. So now if you look at the clean diagram here, the Java programming language, the instructions you write it here, is taken by compilers. It's taken by compilers, and compiler also creates one intermediate language. And this is where the way it creates, Java created, makes it platform independent. And then Java interpreter can take that instructions and give it to either Windows or Ubuntu. Now, and that way, Java becomes platform independent or operating system independent because of this whole concept of creating an intermediate language. And if I remember, you know, no other programming language did this when, you know, before Java. Earlier it was directly from compiler to interpreter and all. There was no such concept of intermediate language. This is how Java works. Now, the major difference, I just want to add one, you know, important concept here is the difference between compiler and interpreter, in case you do not know. Compilers are, you know, every programming language has its set of instructions, a set of rules. Like when you speak English, you put a dot or period to end the sentence. You put space between two words. You use some connector words like and, or. So it has its own grammar. So Java also has its own grammar. Any programming language has its own grammar. So Java compiler ensures that code you write conforms to the standard of Java. And that's why before you run the code, compiler catches all your mistakes. And once everything looks good, you know, it is ready to be converted to, you know, an intermediate language, then Java compiler converts into intermediate language, and then it goes to Java interpreter. Java interpreter's job is to read the intermediate code, that in this code here that we wrote it, this piece, and give that instructions to feed that into machine language, converts that into machine language, because Windows and all reads machine language. Right? So that is what Java interpreter does. And that's all in this concept. I'll see you guys again in the next class. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thanks for watching. Do subscribe and press the bell icon for more videos.